Well, good Thursday morning to you folks. Hopefully things are going well with you. I'm going to read to you from the book of Matthew today, just a thought that I had on my mind. Matthew in chapter 16. We'll pick up in verse 21. From that time forth, Jesus began to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and be raised again the third day. Then Peter took him, and began to rebuke him, saying, Be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee. But he turned and said unto Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan, thou art an offense to me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. Now Jesus understood what was happening here, even when Peter didn't understand. Peter was being used as a tool by Satan. And as he was saying this, Jesus just called it like he saw it. And he spoke to Satan to say, get out of here. Get behind me. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. And I think we could probably all say denying ourselves is one of the hardest parts about being human. If there's something that we want or something that we desire, to stay away from that, to abstain from that is a difficult thing. And especially if we try to do it in our flesh, try to do it on our own. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. So you want to hold on to it, you will lose it, but if you will give it up for him, you'll have life everlasting. And verse 26, for what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? I can't remember for sure. Maybe it was the Leuven brothers. My dad loved to listen to them. And they sang a song, What Would You Give in Exchange? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange for your soul? Though a man could gain the whole world, and trust me, you never will. But Satan puts the smallest things out there in front of us to tempt us with, to try us with, to draw us away. What would it profit you or me if we would gain the whole world? We could get our greedy little hands on everything we thought we wanted. And then when it come down to the very end, to the last breath, to stand before God and hear him say, Depart from me, I never knew you. Somebody said to me once, the Bible is written for Christians. It's not written for a man who doesn't have a relationship with God. And I could understand what he was saying. When we are believers and followers, we must submit ourselves to him, to follow him. We don't do it on our own. Jesus said it is expedient that I go away. If I don't go away, the Comforter will not come. But if I go, he will come, and he will make his abode in you, and he will lead you and guide you in all truths. And so that's what the Holy Spirit does for us. So is it difficult to say no to yourself? Yes, it is. But can it be done? Yes, it can, with the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. So for that man that said to me, the Bible was written for followers of Christ or Christians, then I would have to say that for someone who was not a believer and did not have a relationship with Christ to read those verses, they would say, well, there's no way I can do that. I can't deny myself, take up my cross and follow him. And the cross was just a symbol of dying. He had just spoke to his disciples and Peter rebuked him. He just told them he was going to die. this song is a Hank Williams song. A lot of people have sang it through the years. It's got a good meaning to it. No matter what you could gain, it's not worth it if you lose your soul. People steal, they cheat and lie for wealth and what it will buy. But don't they know on the judgment day their gold and silver will melt away? I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know that my poor soul was saved than to live in this world in a house gold, deny my God and doom my soul. What good is gold and silver too if your heart's not pure and true? Sinner, hear me when I say, fall down on your knees and pray. I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know than my live in this world in a house of gold, deny my God and doom my soul. We all make choices. We have the opportunity to decide which way, how we go, which direction we go. It's up to you and it's up to me. Of course, it is the drawing of the Holy Spirit. We cannot be saved until He draws. But when He draws, we have the opportunity that lays before us to make the choice of what we will do. What would you give in exchange for your soul? Lord, I thank you for the day you've given us. God, I pray that you would direct us, that you would lead us and guide us. And God, you love us, so I know you will. Help us to make the right decisions and the right choices in life. If there be somebody watching this today who does not know you, God, I pray that you will help them to see that it wouldn't matter if they gained everything that they thought their heart desired. It will all burn one day. They will leave it all one day. And God, they will stand before you. So Lord, help us to choose you, for you chose us. We love you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, folks. See you Friday.